welcome to my studio. I wanted to show you how to color the corn husk today. And we're doing a lot of fun projects with them doing Halloween and especially Thanksgiving pumpkins. And we're kind of doing different ones, so they'll be a lot of fun. But I want to give you the basics of how to dye the corn husk. We're going to start with our corn husk, and one of the biggest questions I get asked is where to find them. You can usually find them in the ethnic section, and if you look, they're like in the Mexican food section, as well as we've also found them in the produce section. I've also found them sometimes at Dollar Tree and at the 99-cent store. The cheaper, the better they work. We don't want a lot of preservatives, especially wax, so the cheaper they are, the better they work. And one package goes a long, long ways. And the first thing I do is I take these, and you can see there is tons in here. They're really compressed tight. And I go and soak these in warm water in the sink and pull them out one by one. That's really, really important, because if you just put it like this into the dye, they're not going to dye all the way through. So it's really important to pull them out one by one. So while those are soaking, we're going to go ahead and start our dye. And I like to use the RIT liquid dye. It works so much better. You can find it at the craft stores as well as Walmart. In Walmart, it's in with the, kind of think about where it's at, kind of where the bleach and everything like that would be, those kind of items, kind of in that section. It's not with the craft area, so think about it being there. And you want to, first thing you want to do is shake it very well. And on this, it has different things that you can add, and it's got like for nylon, add a cup of vinegar or different things, and also one of the ingredients is salt. So I add between a half a cup to a cup of salt, and then it says up to a gallon of water, and I usually don't add a gallon of water depending on how many I'm working on. This will actually do two of these really well. So I only put in a half one for one of these. You don't want to put the whole thing in, because it's going to absorb all to this. And when you go to do the second batch, there's going to be nothing left because it absorbs in. So it's real important that you only use half if you're doing a bag full of the tamale or the corn husk, what we make out of tamales out of. And then re-add the second half in here. So go ahead, get some water in here, and I only do enough water to cover my corn husk nicely. I don't put too much water in, because the more water you have, the less absorbent it's going to be. So I'd rather have it more potent. And then put it on, start to bring it to a boil, and also add your salt and then your color. Stir it up really, really well, and then go ahead and add your corn husk. And then if you need to add a little bit of more water, you can, and then stir it up. Another thing I used to do was stick it in and then put something on top of it to keep it push down so that the dye could get on top. And it doesn't go as well because you're not allowing it to get in between each one of them. So I don't do that anymore. I actually kind of take my tongs and move it around as it's going. Once it comes to a boil, just put it on a nice simmer, and you're going to simmer it for as long as you want the color to take. I probably did an hour to 2 hours, like on black, because you want the black really, really dark. It would probably almost take a couple of hours on that. And don't be afraid to add a little bit more color on in if you're not getting that. Now, by bringing it to a boil and getting it nice and hot, you're getting rid of the wax on the corn husk, if there is any. And sometimes it can be kind of a natural wax too. Don't think about an additive. And it makes it absorb better instead of doing it cold. So that is the reasoning behind it. So just keep it going until it gets the color you want. Remember, it's darker when it's wet. So when it dries, it's going to be lighter. And then what I do is if I'm going to do a second batch, and I usually just go ahead and do all my batches at once, so I have this set aside, and if I use it next time, that's fine. It's just a pain to do it again and again, so just get it all done at one time, and even if you wait for next year, that's okay. And then I take my tongs, I'm at the sink, and then I put it right into the sink and wash it off in cold water, so you're kind of setting it. And then I have what's left in here, and then I add my second half of the bottle so I don't have to start all over. I can reuse that, but remember, if you don't add this, it's going to be a way lighter color. And if you want that too, that's fine. That's all right. But if you want it to be consistent in color, you need to re-add that again and then keep on going. Now, once these are dry, I made a mistake with these and I've got to go back and do it. While they're still nice and warm, lay them out flat like the black and just lay them down on one top of each other and go put them in the sun or somewhere where they can dry. If you leave them, they can stay wet for several days. And on some of the projects, I don't mind, especially like this guy, if he's a little bit damp, that's okay. And that's why I had kind of left these, as I was kind of doing that and kind of bending him. So him being damp was a good thing. And that's the reason I didn't do that. But they can stay damp for days if they're stacked on top of each other, especially if the weather's not real warm. So if you want them to dry out, then go ahead and set them one on top of each other and get those dried. On the ones like these two here, we want them flat and wide. And so that's why we're going to go ahead and do that. And like I said, on the other pumpkin, if you're working on him, you may want them just a little bit damper so that you can bend those nice and tight. But that is how we dye our corn husk. If you ever have any questions about anything we're working on, especially including our corn husk, please email me at art@miriamjoy.com. Make sure if you go to miriamjoy.com, on our website, there's a YouTube link, and where I have done a lot of these corn husk garlands and wreath in the past. I did some Christmas ones, I did some Thanksgiving ones. So there's a bunch of items using the corn husk that are a lot of fun. So make sure you check those out. Subscribe to our YouTubes, and that way you get all the fun stuff that's coming out. Thank you. God bless.